another box opening from Wine & Cheese Gaming. Today is the second Kickstarter for Relic Blade. I got it in a couple days ago, but I haven't been able to get things out yet. But I got it out of the package. I got most of the stuff. I can't think of anything I did not get, because the models are just always awesome, and the game's great. So, first things, got some cards. Looks like got one that's signed by Sean. Cool deal. It's the Dark Wanderer. Kind of in color. Kind of there. It's very, as always, it's always good quality stuff. And got a couple more cards to go with it. And then we have the Deep from the Guest Artist. So let's see what this looks like. Just kind of rip this open. Maybe. There. I'm horrible at ripping these things open. Alright. Ooh. In color. Let's see if you can get good shots of those. Very nice. You can definitely tell a different artistic style, but still good stuff. I'm pretty impressed. Alright. I have a faction expansion, Bone in the Darkness. Oh, okay. Let's see what this is. Oh. Alright, so it contains 10 card booster pack. So it's 5 character cards and 5 upgrade cards. 4 metal miniatures, 1 Dark Wanderer, 1 Bone Construct, and 2 Bone Stalkers. And the Dark Ritual special scenario. Very cool. Oh, I like it. So the cover, it's kind of like that Marvel game or Night Game stuff where the rules are like on the part of the cover, which is always really smart. Okay, cool. New rules. Dark Ritual. Got some rules for constructs since, but there we are. I'm sure the cards are going to look pretty much the same. Well, push them down. Alright. Said I'm horrible at opening these. It's not in color, it's their black and white, but still really, really good artwork. Kind of show that off. So, very good. Yeah, all of this cards have been really good the entire time, to be honest. So here's the Dark Wanderer. I'm not really going to go into it because it looks the same. Well, yeah, it's pretty much the same as the other one from the previous Kickstarter. And again, we'll do some close-ups. So we'll do a close-up to that one because it's the same model. At least, well, maybe. We'll do a close-up of it. I don't know who this is. It's a couple dudes. We've got some of their constructs. Alright. I mean, these models are just really nice little skeletons. Different take from, like, GW stuff, which is a welcome sight. I mean, GW stuff's great, but, you know, it's all the same. Here we got a little bit of differences. Okay. Yeah, there's the... I got caught on the last one looking at the arms and thought I was missing an arm, and the arms are just sculpted into the... Okay. It's like, am I missing something? I don't want to do that again. It's like Sean called me out on it last time. It's like, they're all there. We'll get a close-up of them at the end, like always. Here's... Oh, wow. Let's look at these. This is bigger than expected. Really nice. Okay. Just kind of trying to see how it fits all together. Or not. I don't want to be seeing all that. But again, good quality. Really different. Really different type style. Really great. Which is nice. Yeah, my area is all messed up. You probably can't see it, but I can. And here's the Lone Guard faction expansion set. And it's got the 10 booster cards, 4 metal miniatures, Lone Guard Ranger, Lone Guard Warrior, Billman, and a Sabertooth, and a Signal Fire special scenario. Good clamshell, easy to open. Don't like the ones where, like the X-Wing. You know, these kinds where you kind of just tear them open. Again, inside, new rules, little scenario, excellent. And see if these are probably going to be in black and white as well. Nothing wrong with that, just Lone Guard Ranger. Oh, that is just an awesome picture. I really like that Lone Guard. Just really nice. Lone Guard Warrior, Billman, Sabertooth. Oh, I love his art. Oh, it's so great. Let's do a Sabertooth one piece. Okay. Excellent. Alright, just a little bit of flash, not too much. Really fine detail. The pic, this one you probably need to see in person, see how just good it is. How well detailed. Well, we'll do a close-up. Well, hopefully it'll show something of how well that, just the musculature on the dog is really nice. Alright. Oh, this guy's just awesome. Wow. I mean, you can use this guy easily in a D&D game, or Frostgrave, Relic Blade, I mean, just anything. Man, this shield is just... this is just great. And the sword, this is, I think that's one of my favorite models. Not just of Relic Blade, but like one of my favorite models. That's just a lot of character. I just love that shield. Right here's the Billman. Okay. I mean he's a Billman. He looks exactly how you'd picture one. Good little adventuring stuff. Oh, man. These are just great. If you guys didn't get these on the Kickstarter, you should be kicking yourself, because these models are awesome. I mean, I got it for the constructs, and just because it's a great game, but these Lone Guard models are just outstanding. Oh, this archer. Just, okay. These, I cannot say how, he's got the arrow. These are just great. You can tell I'm just all over these. Alright, so, got some extras. We'll get to the book afterwards. My wife will be happy I'll have more. This bubble wrap for her. For those bubble wrap. I can't even remember what I got. I just was just like, give me everything. So, let's see. This is... Oh, that's right. I got two of the yaks. So I only open up one. Because they'll be the same. I heard stuff fly. Oh, there it is. I was like, I'm missing a head. It's because it flew off. Simple, easy to put together. I mean, just look at that. This is a little yak. Perfect for, like, if you're just doing a D&D campaign or just, it's just an objective, it can be just an objective marker or anything. It's just outstanding. I'm using that word a lot, but I can't help it. It's about all I can think of. This is that this hammerhead. Those eyes. The eyes, oh man. This is great. I like the swords, the armor. Again, the quality is just, it's there. You can tell there's not a whole lot of flash on there. The mold lines. I don't expect to have mold lines in something new. And let's see who else we got here. I probably could just look at my invoice and see who's coming in. Okay, another one of the fish people. Or fish heads. It's an interesting neck. Okay. No, I like it. Don't get me wrong. It's just, it's different looking. Oh, he's got a lantern. I have forgotten what I got. It's not that Kickstarter was forever. It's just, I have a bad memory these days. I was more looking forward to what's coming up. And here's Silvar the Sneak. Or, I might have said his name wrong, but it's a sneaky git. Oh, man. And of course, you have the choice of arms, since there's two versions. Just great. We'll get close-ups here in a little bit. But I want to show off the campaign book. Seeker's Handbook. I'm just going to flip through. I'm not going to do too much. Standard game. Where's the horror? Wow. This is just, it's really good quality. The paper is, it's not flimsy. It's good quality paper. I'm a little worried about the binding. I've had bad experience with the binding and the, you know, this kind of binding. Well, that's mostly Flames of War, Battlefront stuff. But, you know, some of the older games, the books will break apart. But the artwork, establishing a base, I love that. Campaigns are awesome. Wow. Okay. This is pretty good. Pack Yak Escort. Sweet. Glad I got some Pack Yaks. Temple Defense. Got plenty of, just the terrain. The fact that it's a small board, you don't need tons of terrain. It's great. It's a lady's favor. Coming as a Bretonian player. It's always good. Nice. There's some extra little stuff in there. I like it. Oh, wow. And you got, of course, you got your roster on the back. Pretty sweet. I have not read any of this yet. I didn't want to know, kind of thing. That's just how I am, but I don't want to know until I have it in my hands, because things change. Hey, join face group. Alright, I already have. Oh, this is just Metal King Studio. Right there. Metal King Studio right there. Good stuff. Good stuff. Alright, we'll get a close-up of these models here. And some of the cards. Maybe not the cards, just because, you know, for prior junior. Yeah, we'll do close-ups. Not even try it. Try it. Alright, we'll be back with close-ups. Alright, so we're going to start with the Pack Yak. See, it's just, and all that little details in there. Good hair. There's the head. And other side. There is the dog, saber tooth. You can definitely see some of them in there. Kind of, sorry about the lighting. It's not the best tonight. I don't know what's up. There's our little, one of our fish guys. And there's my little lone guard. Yeah. So here we are. We have some close-ups on the hammerhead. And his weapons. And we got kind of Silvars or the Sneaks. They're little archer friends. Some of the construct arms. And then the constructs themselves. And big construct, light's not the best here. Then our Billman. Sabertooth, and then our Pachyax. Hopefully you can see the detail on that shield. I just love it. And there we have it. Alright guys, there's my opening of Relic Blade, the second Kickstarter. With our campaign system, we got the Lone Guard, and then the Bones and Darkness faction. I highly recommend getting it. The models, the game's great. I haven't even tried the campaign system, but I know the game's great itself, so I can't doubt that it will not be just as good. And the models, they're awesome. Even if you just want something, I would highly recommend just getting these models. Just for something else, even if you're not playing this game, if you want it for D&D, Pathfinder, some of the other games out there, just, or if you just want to make a diorama or something, I don't know, but these models are great. Those Lone Guards, just excellent. That you can tell, I love the archer in it, but I really like the guard. Oh man, he's just awesome. Constructs are good too if you need to do an undead for anything. You know, you got your evil creatures, or if you play a necromancer. Not that I would ever play a necromancer. Love them. So here you are. Go ahead and check them out. Metal King Studios. Sean's great. He did this pretty much by himself, except for the one little part where he had a guest come in to do a character. So, I mean, for a one-man show, I'm highly impressed, and major props to you, Sean. Thanks a lot for the great game and the great models, and I hope you keep on producing more. Alright, that's it from Wine and Cheese Gaming. You bring the wine, you bring the cheese. Have a good one.